What's up, guys? Justin here, aka MHero25 with a deck profile. I know I just did a deck profile last week, but this week on Sneak Peek Weekend, I decided to run a new, like, well, not a new deck, but a deck I'm familiar with. But I wanted to try something new, and if you can't tell, it's pretty big. So, what I ran today at my Fargo locals at the Sneak Peek tournament was this 60 card Metalfoe, Perfomapal, Zoodiac deck. No, I'm not lying. I'm not making shit up. That is exactly what was in this deck, and I'm gonna break it down for you and just show you what I played today. Cause one of my friends in Houston wanted to know what I was playing, and like, you know, he said like I should play this deck today, and it's like, oh, I didn't think I was gonna do too well. I actually wanted to play dinosaurs. But I felt like maybe I should give this a shot again to see how it went, and oh my god, it went amazingly well. I honestly thought I was gonna scrub out like pretty hard, but I actually went 5-0. Like I only had like one match where I went 2-1. Everything else was like 2-0, 2-0, 2-0. And you know, I'll go in depth in another video in a second, but let me just get to the deck profile. So first off, we're running 3 silvered. 3 Steelin', 3 Gold Driver, 3 Volflame, and only 2 Bismagear. That's all you need for the Metal Foes. Like, you pretty much get to these instantaneously through, like, a lot of other methods. So, don't have to worry about that. Then we're running 1 Dragoons of Draconia for your search targets, for your low scale, and then your high scale Perfomapal King Bear. Which leads me into my Perfomapal engine of 1 Lizard Draw, triple Pendulum Sorcerer, and 1 Skullcrabbed Joker. Now, why do you run these? Simple, low scale, poppable, like the low scale searches a scale, and like a 6 is still something, and it's a level 3, so we can still do some kind of plays. And if you are ever lucky enough to get like the effect to draw one, it's still always good. So that's why I still run those. Triple Eccentric. Really good card. Just like the way I played my deck today, this is not a crucial card, but it came in clutch when it came in. Now moving on, and that's all the pendulums. Now moving on to the non-pendulum cards. Now we run double Whiptail and 1 Ram. That is it. No Rapier, no Thoroughblade, nothing else. Just these 3 cards, and these 3 cards did a lot of work today. They helped me get over a lot of stuff, and they actually stole me a few games. So, if you're wondering why, no one likes a 0-0 Dryden. 2000 Dryden, really good. 28 Dryden, even better. 26 Dryden with attack, oh yeah. Very fun. Next up, my plant engine. 3 Lone Fire Blossoms and 3 Bababoons. Now, why am I running so much of a rank 3 engine? Of a level 3 engine, just because you really want to see MX Saber Invoker as soon as you can. Because as soon as you get your Zoodiac combo off, that's the first thing they want to handle with. They don't even worry about your metal foes. But if you get like all that going off, like it's hard for your opponent to like really weigh what's important and like weigh out the situation there. So that's why I run that. Now, again, another rank 3 engine. 3 Teratops, 1 Taki Tomborg. Shout out to Eric. Eric D. Hashtag 4th Hokage X, if he still uses that old nickname or whatever. But these cards came in clutch today. Like in my last round, like my 5th round, I baited out one of my opponent's cards by, you know, like XYZing into another rank 3 before I went to MX Saber Invoker, and it worked out so well. So good. Another rank 3 engine, 1 tour guide because I have targets already with eccentric, and then I decided to run 1 Sangan. I just thought like Sangan's fun, Sangan's fine, and you don't really need multiple Sangans in this deck. It's fine as it is. Honestly, I sided this out a lot. I only used its effect one time during the whole day, and that was to get Maxi, and that actually came out really handy. And then, of course, speaking of Maxi, because it's only at 1. And then 1 Rescue Rabbit. Now, That's the whole monster. That's all the monsters, and that's pretty much most of the deck, and it was amazing. Like, I never found myself like, oh, this is cloggy. This is bad. I'm going to lose. I'm only drawing monsters. That's what I wanted to see, because these pendulum cards just took care of themselves. To help turbo that out, though, I even played two Summoner's Art, which helped me get my Volflames all the time. Two painful decisions to get any of my lower scales I needed to help set up my scale. And then I played three MSDs, you know, to get those combination pops when you need them, or just even, like, hit back row. It's honestly, like, you can... This had so much more versatility than Twin Twister, in my opinion, just because it either allowed me to gain advantage in my hand, allowed me to get rid of pesky cards, or, you know, even free up a space if I had to set up a pendulum scale. My one-ofs, now, these are interesting. I played one My Body as a Shield. This is standard, because you just... Even with Metalfoe or Zoos, you hate board wipes. Emergency Teleport. I ran this simply because I ran this with the theory of, okay, so if I don't have another monster to fuse with, at least gonna do this, or if I can go for game with this. And that at least gets me, like, you know, like, eight of my targets. So either free pop, free attack, or free fusion material. Either way, it was all pretty good. Never really used it. And, you know, there wasn't a time where, like, I really wanted E-Emergency. You keep saying E-Emergency call, but Emergency Teleport. But still, it was still good to have in here. One Upstart Goblin to make 60-59. Like, it made a difference. One Red Geki. And then my Full Metal cards, my fusion cards, Full Metalfoe Fusion, and then one Metalfoe Fusion. Two counter, one combination, and I played a little trap lineup of two strikes, one warning. This came out really well. Actually, this only came out. None of these came out. Everything else in this deck cycled out way faster. Like, I never sat to the point where, like, oh man, I need negations. Like, I was fine. Now off to the extra deck. I ran two Mithrilium, one Adamante, one Orichalc, and one Alkahest. Honestly, these are the MVPs of the day. These did work. These helped me clear board. This one helped me clear boards, helped me remove problems. I used this once, and it actually did pretty well. Like, it gave me, like, a 25 beater. Never used Alkahest, but it's always good to have him just in case to handle situations that you can't handle with destruction. And now Onchi exceeds, which is, like, most of the extra deck. One Borbo, one Broadbull, one Tiger Mortar, and two Dryden. Honestly, there were many times I won a double Broadbull, but I didn't have one, and also I couldn't find room to even take out anything. Like, everything was necessary. Like, even Borbo had its point where it's like, you know, either free material, or if I had to, like, overlay it, attack directly. Yeah. And, you know, even Tiger Mortar was just free material, and, you know, just, like, another leg up. So, wouldn't change much about that, except maybe another Broadbull. For the rest, one Digusto Emerald, one Abyss Dweller, and for my threes, one Super Quantum Mega Beast Grandpulse, MX Saber Invoker, and Breaksword. Honestly, these... I went in this one at my last game, which was Clutch. Never went to Emerald. I was surprised, though. Like, you know, I put Emerald in here because I knew, like, Zoodiacs always have this problem where they need to recycle, but it never came up. I never needed it, and I never needed to really reuse my stuff. Grand Pulse was just in case, like, got anti-spelled or some field spell or some spell card I can't handle, like, with normal way, so this is in case. Bistwater came in clutch. When I was playing against my last match was Shiranui Zombies, and, you know, when I got, I was somehow able to clear off two Omegas, a Minerva, and a Snow, put this out on the board beforehand, and then as soon as I passed turn, I chained effect to say you can't use their effects in grave, and it was just amazing. Bait card and MVP of the day. Bait card, MVP of the day. This card just put pressure on my opponent more than I thought it would. Just because if I had combination set or any card I didn't really care about, I could pop in and just get like a free, you know, removal. And Amex Saber Invoker just, oh god, just, oh my god, just, I'm sorry, I'm flabbergasted. It's just, Ram plus Viper is just so powerful and I love it. Anyway, that's the main deck. I usually don't show you side decks, but I'm going to show you mine just because it was an interesting build, and I just want to show you what was really useful and what wasn't really useful at all today. So let's start it off with the monsters. Only ran two, just Jinzo. And because I saw Paleozoic today, I didn't want to deal with it at all, so I just ran that. Never sided it in, never saw Paleozoic at all today. My one of is one Dark Hole, because board clear against Zoodiacs is necessary. And Pot of Acquisitiveness. This is like a tech choice I always put in for like almost every one of my side decks, because I hate it when my shit gets banished, and I like to at least recuperate. I hate when my opponent thinks I'm out of the duel because they banish one card, and this just comes out of nowhere. Not only do I get my resources back, I draw one, so always good in my opinion. Next up, three Typhoons. I'm trying to find my third one. Oh, nope, only two Typhoons in this one, so only two Typhoons. Really good. I played three Lost Winds. This one came in clutch today because, whenever they tried to swing for a game, it was just like, no, half the attack can't kill me. It was really good. Next up, two Imperial Iron Wall. I started this a lot against Dinosaurs and also against the Sheer New deck. Never saw it, but it came in handy. I felt better with it in there. And then my last four cards I teched in today, two XYZ Universe, and my targets for XYZ Universe, one Duo Don King Kali Yuga and Odd Eyes Raging Dragon. Now, I did make a video about this earlier, and I don't think anyone saw it, but again, let me explain why I played this card over Red Eyes. Simply because when this card is summoned, I don't use anything more than just a beat stick of 3,000, 25 defense, but when it's destroyed is where it really matters. So when it's destroyed, instead of going to the graveyard, it goes to the Pendulum Zone first. So this is a free scale 1. And that, of course, has to be vacant. But the effect that really matters is the one in the Pendulum Zone. During your turn, you can place, not activate or anything. You can place one Pendulum card from your deck to the field. So that usually means, in my mind, Eccentric. I've done this before, and it's amazing where you activate Eccentric, pop back row, place one of your other scales, pen summon everything back out, get this, get another Eccentric, pop it, use its skin to pop a monster, and keep going. And if they even do get rid of this, I'm not sure about how the ruling would go, but, you know, it can, in the effect, it can still be pendulum summoned if you can get a 7 out. So, again, this is like an infinite loop of, like, just dealing with a monster that's 3,000, 2,500, can put a scale for free, and then can be summoned out all over again. So it's really good, and I find it to be a really awesome card. Anyway, guys, that's my video. Thanks for watching. I hope you guys liked it. If you have any questions or comments about this deck, let me know in the comment section down below. Don't forget to like it, by the way. And with that being said, this is Justin, aka MHero25, signing out. Peace.